Namaskar students, we will be continuing with the second chapter on economic development. In our previous class, we have been discussing about the different reform programs that were brought in by the policymakers of independent India in the agricultural sector. Today, we will be discussing in details about the Green Revolution program, which was another reforms that has been brought about by the policymakers of independent India. Now, we have been discussing that India is mainly an agricultural country. That is, during the colonial rule also India was an agricultural country, and post independence also India had been an agricultural country where 75% of the population depended on agriculture for their livelihood. But the agricultural productivity in India was very low, the reason being lack of use of modern technologies, or there was not much of infrastructures for the farmers. Now, Indian agriculture, if you see, mainly dependent on the monsoons. So if the monsoons fell short of, then the farmers were at a loss because they did not have any alternative arrangements for water supply. They did not have any irrigational facilities. Now, this stagnation which was prevailing in the agricultural sector during the colonial period was permanently brought to an end by using this reform, which was very effective, that is the Green Revolution program. Now, what is this Green Revolution program? Now, the Green Revolution program refers to a period in India when the Indian agriculture was gradually being converted. It was being given a new look. That is, modern methods were being used, technologies were much improved, such as high yielding variety of seeds were being used, tractors were made available to the farmers, better irrigational facilities were brought in, then pesticides and fertilizers were made available to the farmers. So it was a total package where a lot of improvements in the agricultural sector was made. Now, coming to the impact of Green Revolution. Now, what happened is that, see, during the first phase of the Green Revolution, there was a use of high-yielding variety of seeds which increased the production. Now, these were not made available to the states like, say, Punjab or Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, because they were already producing, or they were very affluent in the production of the agriculture. So, it was made available to the other states. Now, what was the impact of the Green Revolution is that we see there was an increase in the production. So the use of high yielding variety seeds, then fertilizers, pesticides, improved educational facilities has remarkably increased the production. Now you could see that there was an increase in the production of crops like wheat, rice, sugarcane, cotton, maize, etc. Apart from that, if you go to the agricultural research part, you will see that there was a use of high yielding variety of seeds. So better methods were being implemented for controlling insects, which also resulted in higher production. Third important impact was fertilizers. Now, since this fertilizers were made available to the farmer, so that also helped in raising the agricultural production. Again, multiple cropping also was made possible during this Green Revolution. That is, due to new seeds maturing early, it was possible to get three or even four crops instead of one or two crops from the same piece of land in a year. So overall, all this led to what is that the agricultural production increased. And since the agricultural production increased, India became more self-sufficient in the agricultural productivity. Now, the farmers obviously kept the first part of their production for their personal consumption. But how would the economy benefit? See, the problem was the economy will only be benefiting only when there was a surplus after the personal consumption, which could be sold. So, this surplus of agricultural production was called the marketable surplus. Now, what happened is that a good amount of rice, wheat produced during the Green Revolution period was sold by the farmers in the market. So, as a result, what happened? The price of the food grains in the market slowly declined. So, the low income group could also now buy a lot of food, because earlier they had to spend a lot of their income on food, but now they were benefiting due to Green Revolution. They had to spend less to get their food or the other grains like wheat, rice, etc. So slowly and gradually the nation was becoming self-sufficient. So the nation had overall, if you see, had been immensely benefiting from the Green Revolution with the use of technology, which was the new technology, the better quality of seeds, irrigational facilities, fertilizers has helped them to benefit. Now, But all these benefits, there was certain kind of risk also because of the new technology, because it would increase the disparities among the small farmers and the big farmers. Because see, this type of technology and etc. could be made available to the big farmers, but small farmers cannot afford everything. But the government made such policies that it was made available to both the small farmers and the big farmers. So eventually what happened was that the productivity increased. So Green Revolution benefited the small as well as the rich farmers, and overall India had seen a major increase in the agricultural productivity. So this is all about Green Revolution. Read whatever the points have been given in your book also, and if you have any problems, just clarify it from me. We'll keep it till here, and in the next class we'll continue with the next topic. Namaste.